Hi there and welcome to Yorkshire Live. And with it being results day for thousands of school children up and down the country, we have a bit of a GCSE special.
Indeed, yeah. We'll be at Brooksbank School talking to some of the students there as they receive their results.
End of 2017 it would have been. I was in hospital for about 8 weeks. I've not really been back to school full time since. I had brain infection.
So, and with all things considered, you've done absolutely fantastically. So, yeah, be super, super proud of yourself. I'm sure your family are really proud as well.
Yeah, mum were crying.
Oh, bless her, that's lovely. How were you feeling before you got your results? Were you quite nervous?
I'm very scared. I think I've done pretty well, to be honest.
Fantastic, congratulations. And so college is the next plan, the next step?
Yeah, hopefully Greened College, which is in Huddersfield.
And mum, you must be so proud.
Absolutely.
Plus, we'll be having a chat with Jamie Berry, who is a successful musician with no music GCSE. That's all coming up. But now let's take a quick look at your latest main local headline. And Headingley Stadium is set to become one of the city's largest concert venues, but only for 2 occasions a year.
Yeah, members of Leeds City Council's licensing subcommittee have come to an agreement at last there as plans which would see the stadium given permission to host music concerts on the pitch go ahead with a capacity of just under 10,000. The panel had met last week to discuss the plans for which the applicants wanted to host up to 4 concerts a year at the Leeds Rhinos rugby ground, but following opposition from local residents, an agreement could not be reached during the meeting.
The council has now confirmed that permission has been granted, but only for 2 events each year, one evening and one afternoon event, with additional conditions in relation to monitoring noise. That's it for just now.